Thanks so much for asking. Janina Gavankar is set to enter the world of Borderlands. The Indian actress and director are set to play Commander Knox, a new character being introduced to the Lionsgate movie. The cast for the video game adaptation includes Cate Blanchett, Kevin Hart, Jamie Lee Curtis, Ariana Greenblatt, Florian Muntaneau, Haley Bennett, Edgar Ramirez, and Jack Black. A feature film based on the popular video game set on the abandoned fictional planet of Pandora where people search for a mysterious relic. Directed by Eli Roth and starring all the cast we mentioned and now Janina Gavankar. Is it Gavankar? I'm sorry, I had the Y cut off earlier.
Yep, it is.
Sorry.
So, a little known trivia for Janina there.
Is that Amy can't pronounce her name. I am so sorry.
No, it's. I mean, me and her actually go way back, man. Like best friends. She doesn't know because it's not true. Mm-hmm. But I mean, we used to date in elementary school, like third grade, mm-hmm. man. She was like mm-hmm. young. So Janine Call. I mean, I miss you, man. We've been. This actress has been one of my favorite actresses for years. I remember the first thing I've ever seen her in. What I think it was True Blood. And it was a typical thing.
I'm trying to
think
if I know her from anything.
First thing was True Blood. Then she's done a lot of things. But the second thing that I noticed.
Oh, it is Gavankar. I'm sorry. I'll get it right.
Next thing I noticed her in was she also starred in a Star Wars novel that was kind of half featured in one of the video games. It was like you could play the video game, then you can learn about this character in the novel. It turns out she's a huge like geek, like one of the, like this. This is like one of those people, like a Ryan Reynolds type of thing or a Henry Cavill type of a person. Like, it's not fair that Ryan Reynolds and Henry Cavill and whatnot have all this great talent, have the all these great looks. And on top of that, they're like, seem to be like the nicest people in the world. It's like, this is crazy. Like, it's not fair. Why can't they be my best friends and call me every weekend, right? But she seems to be one of those people. And I fell in love with this person. Maybe just on one show, you know, obviously a typical thing like, oh my gosh, she's so beautiful. But then when you learn about her, it's like, this person is amazing. A musician, a director, actress, musician. I mean, she's and a geek. When I heard she was going to be in this movie, instantly made me go, I'm now going to watch. I had no interest in watching this movie.
It's like someone got back in line when they were giving out the good traits. Like, come on. I'm working with like half a good quality here, Janina.
I'm barely making it on a gift, and she has all the damn talent. Come on, yeah. but no, I was interested in watching Borderlands, this video game based movie because I heard
that's Kevin, a pretty stacked cast.
Yeah, Kevin Hart, and I was like, what? Kevin Hart?
I mean, I feel like Jamie Lee Curtis is always like,
always solid, always a classic, always. But I had no interest in watching this movie until I heard the cast that they were getting. I'm like, okay. They're really taking this one seriously. Honestly, the real reason that the thing that made me go, I'm going to watch it definitely was when I heard Kevin Hart was in it. Cause I was like, is he going to be funny or is he going to be a serious? I can't tell. Usually a movie I can tell he's going to definitely be funny in this one, but this, I wouldn't be surprised if it's serious or comedic. I'm hoping serious.
That'd be fun.
That would be fun for me.
How he does.
Because I like it when he does drama, when he tries to flex that muscle. What about you? I know you're not really much of a gamer, as great as an awesome gamer as I am. But come on, Borderlands. I mean, you and Eric, I mean, you got to be playing Borderlands, right?
I've never played Borderlands. I'm not super familiar.
I've never played it either. I'm not going to lie.
But I think that's always interesting, too, of like how can they... You're obviously... Here's the thing. They're coming in with this cast. They're coming in with Eli Roth. They're clearly going to try to, and I know it's a very popular game, but you don't put that level of talent and money behind something if you are not going to try to make it as accessible as possible for people who aren't familiar with the game. You wouldn't be getting these actors if it was going to just be that's great if you've played the game. So I will be curious to see sort of how they build that out and make it accessible while still, you know, making the fans happy if they can do it.
You know, you're right, and I've been saying it for a long time that is it time for the video game revolution for movie adaptations to begin? Like, because we've been getting all these sucky movies for years, and and it's ironic that it was Sonic the Hedgehog that's kind of started it off. Like, I, if I'm not mistaken, this was the first major motion picture release video game movie to get Resident Evil. Resident Evil got a bunch of sequels, but did it make as much money as Sonic did? I think Sonic the Hedgehog made the most any other video game movie has made so far. I might be wrong about that. I'm gonna have to look that up. But Sonic the Hedgehog was a recent success that's making me hopeful for the future of video game adaptations, because it's been horrible.
Yeah,
and we'll talk about it.
Which is a shame, because it is such a, you know, I think video games have really come up in the last, you know, decade or so. Not that there wasn't always good work happening, but really become like a
translation,
a contender, and like you can have some incredible narrative storytelling as well, and some really interesting worlds. So why not use those? Why not tap that?
Right. Yeah, that's what I always say. So why not tap that? Let us know what you guys think about the upcoming Borderlands 3 and the cast, the stack cast that we have in this upcoming film. Because, you know, my homegirl, best friend for life, she hits me up on the DMs all the time just to say, hey, how you doing, Chris? I'm like, oh, I'm great. How are you? This is a total lie. I'm putting it out there in the universe.
He's catfishing himself. He made a Janina Gavankar account and sent himself messages. Someone needs to help him.
I love her so much, it hurts. I can't stand it. But let me put it in the box below, guys, about what you think about this movie. And maybe we'll talk about it in an upcoming We Got Your Mail.
If you like what you saw, make sure to subscribe to the channel and please drop a like on this video. It really does help us. Also, don't forget you can turn on notifications so you don't miss a single review, react, why is that trending, or we got your mail.